I'm Amy Stewart. This is Lady Cop Makes Trouble, the second book in the Cop Sister series. In this novel, I'm telling the true story of Constance Cop's first few months on the job as New Jersey's first female deputy sheriff. So it's the fall of 1915, and in Hackensack, New Jersey, Constance has just stepped into her new role. One of her jobs is to look after the women inmates at the jail. Now, this was a common role for women in law enforcement to have at that time. They were more like social workers, looking after the women and children who came through the law enforcement system. Women officers were generally not given a gun, a badge, handcuffs, or arrest authority, which means the right to chase a bad guy down and put him under arrest. But believe it or not, Constance had all of that. She had the same rights and responsibilities as any male officer. And what's even more astonishing is that Sheriff Heath paid her the same as he paid the male deputies at a time when generally women made less than half of what men made if we could get any job at all. So in this first case, Constance is helping to chase down an inmate who escaped from the jail. Now, I'm lucky that I have a lot of detail about this case. I have a mugshot of the guy. I have detailed newspaper articles that track his every move across New Jersey and New York. I even have a kind of silly newspaper illustration imagining what it would look like if a lady cop caught a male fugitive. Now, there was a lot at stake for Constance on this case. It was unheard of for a woman officer to go chasing down a male suspect in those days, so this made newspaper headlines all over the country and really put her under a spotlight. What's even worse is that if this fugitive wasn't caught, Sheriff Heath wouldn't just lose his job. In New Jersey at that time, the law said that if an inmate escaped, the sheriff could be required to serve out the rest of the inmate's sentence. He could have been locked up in his own jail for this. Now, you can read the historical notes in the back of the book to see what's real and what's fiction, but most of it's true. And there's also a lot more information on my website, and I do Skype chats with book clubs, so feel free to take a look at all of that and get in touch with me. I hope you enjoy the book, and there's a lot more to come.